Hello everyone, today I'm going to show you how to use Photo Story on your laptops to create a little digital essay photo story type thing. This is going to be used for our community projects, so once you're logged into your computer, you can just head over to the Start menu. If you don't see Photo Story 3 here, it's probably because you haven't used it recently. You would go to All Programs, and you should be able to see it up in the top here, Photo Story 3. You click on that, open it up, and it's going to ask you if you want to begin a new story, edit a project, or play a story. So I'm going to begin a new story. I'm working on my community project. This is the first thing it requires you to do is bring in pictures, because it's going to show a slideshow that you can record audio over and kind of make a photo story. So I'm going to import pictures. It's going to go right to my My Pictures folder, if that's where you happen to have your pictures saved. Great. If not, you can choose your picture, your document, your folder that has your pictures in here. These are the pictures that I chose that I wanted to use for my community project, so I can choose them. If I press Control and A, it will select all of them. If I click on one and hold Control while I click on another, it'll select just those ones that I hold Control and click on. If I choose one, hold Shift and click on another one, it'll usually choose all the ones kind of in that area. So I'm going to choose them all, click OK. It imports them all. You can see down here, here's just in kind of a random order. All my pictures, I can click on them and see, I can edit them if I need to, I can change the cropping, I can turn on some contrast filters, I can add some effects by making it black and white, I can also do this later on too if I wanted to, but I'm kind of just going to leave my pictures the way they are. If I need to rotate them, I can do so here, but I'm not really going to edit any of those pictures. That is an option that you could do. I do want to move some though. This is the order of the pictures that they've got. Actually, I don't want to use this picture because it just hasn't really come out right. So I can click this X over here, and it deletes the picture. This one I don't want to use either. These are GIF images. They just didn't come out too right when they got imported, so I'm deleting those. But I want to move, like, I want to start with this one. So I can either click on it and drag it to the beginning here, and it will start at the beginning. Or I can, see what picture do I want to go next. I think I will show this one here. I can click these arrows and it will move it, the one that I have selected, either forward in the timeline or later. I'll put this one next. Alright, I'll put this one next. Then once you've got all your pictures in order, you can click next, or you can choose to remove black borders. You see here I've got black borders based on the size of the image. You can click to remove black borders and it will kind of analyze the pictures and suggest a cropping for them. And you can choose if you want it to be cropped that way or not. This one, I don't really want to be cropped because there's a cat working with a dog standing up there to drink some water. So I'm going to say no, I don't want to crop that one because it would kind of remove a lot of the information. This one, yeah, I want to crop it, but I want the tops of their heads in it. I don't really need the stuff in the bottom, so I'll say yes to that. So you can just go through that and do that individually how you need to for pictures. Then you can click next, and it will bring you to a place where you can add titles to your pictures. You type your text in this area here. I've got my picture selected down in the bottom. You can add text here. Like, I want to write, what is community? I want that. See how it comes up right on that image. But I don't really want it to be in the middle there. So these, I'll show the alignment if I want it to be to the left, centered, or to the right. And these three buttons here will align it to the top, to the center, or to the bottom, so you can really adjust wherever it's going to be in your on your image. This button here, you can change the fonts, so I can change it to size 20 font and bold, and I can make it modern number 20. There's all different types of text that you can use. You can also change the color of the text and underline it if you'd like. So just a few different options there. Maybe I'll go with silver, see what that looks like. Yeah, it doesn't look that good. I'll go with black again. Alright. And I'll center it. And you can change effects again, like I showed in the other editing place, but you can do what you want, but I want to keep the picture the same. You can go right through each picture and add titles, and however you would like. So if you would like to, you can continue adding titles to different pictures. You can just add them in here the same way I did in that one. Once you've added all your titles to pictures, you click next again. This is one of my favorite areas where you can actually record different voiceovers to each image, and you can type notes to yourself in here. So I might want to say, this is what I'm going to say, this is kind of my script. Let me ask yourself, what is going to be? You don't have to write exactly what you want, but it's just some notes for you to help you when you're recording. When you click on this red button, it'll record, and then you can click stop, and it will record just for this image. So, I'm going to give it a shot. You might ask yourself, what is community? And then you can preview it. It'll actually preview the whole thing, but you'll get to hear what you're recording.
You might ask yourself, what is community?
So, that's not too bad. I'll deal with that. Also, this is a great place to go customize motion. There are motions that it will sometimes add where it slides across the screen, and it's pretty cool. You can also change the time setting here. So once you click down this button, it'll drop the time that it shows that the 3.5 seconds. It's automatically 5, but it'll change it to 3.5 seconds for how long it's showing the video. I clicked all the way down. Since I recorded something, my recording was 3.5 seconds, so it'll stop. Once I've recorded something, it'll stop and won't go any shorter than my actual audio recording was. Let's check that out so there won't be a little bit of a gap anymore. Let's check this preview again.
You might ask yourself, what is community?
And then it goes right to the other picture instead of waiting another second and a half. Also, you can go up to here, transition. And there's all sorts of cool transitions that you can add. So this is going from nothing because I didn't have a previous picture to another transition. I can save that. I'll add some text here. Write a note for myself. Community is when people support each other. A community is when people support each other. So I just recorded that. Let me preview that, see if it came out okay.
A community is when people support each other.
There was a little bit of button clicking there at the end. I pushed the record button again. I'm going to delete that. So if I click this arrow, it'll delete that. It'll ask me if I want to. I said yes, so I'm going to record it again. Oops. Delete that. All right, here we go. A community is when people support each other. Preview that.
A community is when people support each other.
Pretty good. And I'll just record another one here. I'm not going to write notes to it. And work together to create a better environment for everyone. Just kind of made that up as I was going. So let's check out the preview. I'm going to click on the beginning. Preview the what I've got so far.
You might ask yourself, what is community? A community is when people support each other.
Notice there's a gap there.
And work together to create a better environment for everyone.
Now I kind of want to make it seamless there. Now I want to make this more seamless, so I want to trim these times down. So I'll change this instead of setting the duration and the time automatically. I'll set it and click it all the way down until it is the length that my recording was. And plus I want to add transitions between those. Try this one out. That looks kind of neat. And this one, I'll change the motion a little too. See here, this shows the start position. So if you click here, I can edit that start position. I want it to kind of start here and like drag across where these guys have been working. And I'll change the time to match how long my recording was. Save it, close it. Let's preview that whole thing again.
You might ask yourself, what is community? A community is when people support each other and work together to create a better environment for everyone.
And so you can hear that clicking, I think, because I'm using like the actual button. If you want to use the mouse pad and just tap it, that will probably be better for you. I'm not very used to doing that. But. Once you've recorded the audio for each of your pictures and changed your motion, customized your motion settings, your durations, everything that you want to customize, you can hit next. That will bring you to the background music section. You could either, I think this is pretty interesting, select music from a file music that you've downloaded, or create your own music. I'll show you that real quick. For create music, it gives you, you can choose a genre, classical, country, dance. I'm of course going to choose dance. You can choose a style of dance, dance hop, power dance. I'm going to choose club mix. Then it gives you some different types of bands. I'm going to choose space guitars because that sounds pretty awesome. And you can choose a mode too. I'm gonna try legendary. Then you can change tempo. I'm going to go pretty slow because this is kind of a slow photo story. But I want high intensity. Let's see what happens. And it comes up with some pretty funny stuff. Yeah, that's pretty legendary. So yeah, it'll make some kind of different music. I could change this to be jazz, acoustic, anxious, and medium and normal, and get something different. Interesting. So, funny stuff to play with, or you can actually load in your own music. Let's see, I think I've got, my removable drive. Let's see, I think I've got something here. Oops. Yeah, I'll choose this song, I'll load that in there, and why don't I preview it?
You might ask yourself, what is community? A community is when people support each other and work together to create a better environment for everyone.
And then of course I would probably record actual stuff for this part and make some titles, but I don't want to do a whole project, just want to show you how to make your own. So that's the preview. I've got it set up the way I want. I click next, and it's going to ask me how do I want to make this story. We're going to want to save it for playback on the computer. It is kind of neat that you could actually send an email with it or save it for a smartphone or something. But we really want to just go with saving it for the computer. You can choose where you're going to save it, so you might want to choose a, mine's going automatically into my videos. If that's where it's going, that might be a good thing. I did a little practice one here earlier, so I'm going to save it. You can change the title of it. I'm going to change it so I know it's mine. It's going to automatically save as a WMV, and you can change settings. Let's just leave those the way they are now, and you hit next, and it will automatically start building the story, mixing the audio, and doing all of that stuff. Doesn't take too long. If it does take a little bit longer for yours is probably going to be a longer video. That's okay. Gives you this completion at the end. Asks you if you want to view your story or create another. Why not just view it and check it out and see
what you think. Ask yourself, what is community? A community is when people support each other and work together to create a better environment for everyone.
So PhotoStory is a pretty neat software program. I think you'll have a lot of fun with it. It's on all your laptops. You can use it for many different projects. This community project is going to be a really great one to create your photo stories and kind of explain what you know about community and what you think about it. So hopefully you enjoy it. Have a lot of fun. Thanks for watching.